Hello there, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. So on this video, we're going to talk about Gmail settings that will transform your inbox experience. Now for the first settings for this one, this is going to be Gmail, right? Before we head on for the first settings, I want you to duplicate your tab first. Simply click on duplicate for that one, so we have two Gmail tabs here. One for refreshing and checking the landing page, one for checking and changing the settings. So go to settings right there. Please choose See All Settings. As you can see right here, under the Generals tab, make sure you are under the Generals tab. Because we have, I think, 8 tabs right there, starting from General up to Themes. Now, going back on General, just click on Control F in your keyboard. You should see this one, the Find toolbar. Type in Snippets and you're gonna have this. Before I click Save here and check No Snippets, I want you to have a preview how it looks like. So it's very cluttered, right? Now, what if I click on Save Changes for this one? Still cluttered, but what if I refresh the screen here? And right now, it's now free of clutter. Pretty awesome, right? And trust me, this is much better. And now I know some of you are not really reading those snippets right there. Personally, I don't like that. So this might help one, alright? Let's move on for the next feature. Now for the next feature, you are gonna see this hover settings option. Now each email, if you hover it out, you're gonna see these options right there, starting from archive, delete the message or email, mark as read, and snooze. Now there is gonna be a much more faster and efficient way to do this later part of the video, but for now, let's disable this one. So going back on settings, as you can see right here, and just click on Control F and look for hover. So we have hover right here, enable or disable. Simply click on disable and basically click on save changes. So what we're doing right now is basically decluttering our inbox, making it more secure, faster, and basically have privacy, of course, as much as Gmail allows. Now, whenever you hover your mouse there, you won't see those hover actions anymore. You're gonna see this unsubscribe option, which is, trust me, if you have so much subscription, this is what you want. With one simple click of a button, you can see unsubscribe button all the way. Now, going back on settings for the next feature, this is about reply and unsend. Again, Control F, type in reply, and basically for this one, the default reply should be on reply and not reply all. Again, it should be on the reply only, and I'll tell you why in a few seconds. For the undo send option, this is my favorite option also in Gmail, wherein you can set a time limit on your cancellation period. Now, what this does is if you compose an email, like so, let me just compose something, and you want to unsend it, especially if you have a boss that doesn't really love you that much anyway, you can simply click on undo and that email will pop up again for an edit option. This is actually a very helpful tip for corporations where you don't want to really send some unnecessary emails to your bosses. Now for the next feature, this is going to be under settings again, so every topic here will be under settings. Now click Control F, click on bottom labels, should be this one right here, sorry about that. Now under bottom labels, it should look like this. Currently, I am on text. Now, I'm going to show you what it looks like for text if you haven't any idea. So, if you open email, you're going to see this. They're currently on text. Found out some people, much like this one, likes the text options. However, some people want the icon option. So, like here, if I click on icon, click save changes. Now, open an email of any email I want. Right now, they're back in icon. Now, some people want it as an icon. Some people want it as a text. That depends on your perspective. So please make sure you check the new one out and make sure you choose which one you really want. Now for the next settings, again going back on settings right there. In here, if you type in keyboard shortcuts, like this one right here, that would be keyboard shortcuts, right? So currently it's off. If I click on here, click on save changes, and this is where it's getting interesting. Let me just open some very simple email here. So right there, these are the keyboard shortcuts. So K for jump next to email. Shift plus T, this is going to be adding it to a Google task. E is archive, V is going to be label, plus archive, or just L for label. B for snooze, R of course going to basically reply to sender, and A to reply to all. Now let's try this one out. If I click on K here, it gives me the option to move to another email. Pretty awesome, right? Let's try this one, Shift T. If I click on Shift T for this one, it adds it to a Google task. How powerful is that, right? Now for this one, let's try letter E here, and it goes to archive. As you can see right there, there's an option to undo. Now moreover, we're gonna have this one. Let's just try letter V. So letter V is gonna be choosing a label and moving it to archive. For example, I wanna click on sample label right there. It's gonna be moved to sample label, can be found right here. Pretty awesome, right? Also, we have here snooze right there. Let me just go back on inbox right here. Click on snooze, that will be letter B. And we have a snooze option until what time of the day. You can customize your specific date. And last also, or second to the last, is reply to sender and reply to all. So if you click on R here, you can reply your own email. Now going back here, if I open this one, for example, and click on A, basically reply to all. How awesome is that, right? Now next setting, since you already know this K, wherein you can just check your emails by letter K right here. However, this option gives you the only option to choose in which of the email that's going to be open. For example, these two emails right here. You cannot really open the one that's not really open just yet. So how to do this or fix it? Go to settings, open that one, go to advanced. Right here, look for the advanced, so this gives us the option to, instead of your inbox after you delete, archive, or mute, you can select whether to advance to the next or previous conversation. Click on OK. Now go back on general, but before you go back on general, click on save changes, like so. Go back on settings on that option right there. It's making sure we always click on save. And for this one, choose advanced. And in here, you're gonna have an option. After archiving, deleting, or muting our conversation, go to the next newer conversation, previous, or get back to your thread list. Now there is a golden rule. Golden rule is always to go to the newer one. However, this is gonna be by your own preference. On my end, I'm gonna go for the next new conversation, of course. Click OK for that one. Now, let's click on this one right here. Click K. So everything right now is basically moving to the next conversation. As you can see right there, it opens up everything altogether, not just skipping one conversation to another. Now for the next feature, I think this is the most important one for all other people. Type in importance here. So there should be important signals for ads. Click on this option right there. I'll see you once inside. Now once you're here, you're gonna get directed on My Ad Center. You can just simply click this one and turn it off. What it does is, it removes all personalized ads on your Gmail. How awesome is that, right? You don't have to suffer that anymore. Just make sure you click on save once you're done. Now since we have removed ads there, make sure you select this one also. This next feature, which is gonna be nudges, make sure these are turned off. Make sure click on save for this one, and basically for it, click on inbox. Now once you're here, you're gonna see those 5 days or reminder, which is gonna be looking like this. All right, let me just pull out the screenshot I have here. I know you're familiar with this one. You always see this on your emails, so you won't receive this anymore if you turn out that option I showed you earlier. Now going back for the next feature, this is gonna be still under C settings, under general tab. Control F and look for the one that says signature. So signature is gonna be an option where you can really add your signature. First, of course, need to create your very own for this one. And let's just say for this, E Galvez, something like that. And I'm gonna go for Tutorialboxx for this one. Click create. Now for this one, this is gonna be the name of your signature. Just make sure you have it right here, whatever you wanna type here. So that would be Tutorialboxx things, something like that. And make sure this is gonna be ticked out. So whenever you write a message to someone or reply to someone, they're gonna feel that you're always having that signature. As you can see right there, I did not type this one, okay? And basically that's it. So that's gonna be the feature for the signature. Let's move on for the next one. Now going back for this one, I think this is gonna be the best out of these all features. Since I don't want clutter on my Gmail, go to settings, and in here, look for chat and meet. Make sure this is gonna be turned off. For example, this is turned on, right? Click save changes. And for this, you're gonna see some major changes, like this one right here. You're also gonna see those and this one right there. Everything is cluttered. You also have this one right here where you have an online option for chat, of course. So again, make sure you disable that one since you're not really using it most of the time. So that will be click off. And then for the meet, hide right there. Meet settings, disable this one and she'll be good to go. And with that, we're gonna go back on a much more clean and decluttered Gmail account. Now next feature, this is still again decluttered. As you can see right here, it's still a little bit more cluttered for my end. So click on settings right there, see all settings. Now, should be under labels, not general, okay? Labels and you have here, starting from inbox, starts, news, important, up to, I think, promotions. And we also have our labels right there. Now this is going to be by your own preference. However, on my end, I do not also use start, so I'm going to hide that one. Hide news, I'm going to hide chats for here. And for the send, I'm going to show it. Schedule, I'm going to hide it. Drafts, of course, I'm going to show it. All mail, I think this should be hidden also since we have inbox earlier. Spam and trash should be hidden also. And for the labels, I'm not going to use them anymore. So basically for this, I'm going to hide it. Or there's going to be an option if there is going to be an inbox for it. You can still click on show if unread. So every time that there is going to be an email inside the label, you can see it. And then if someone reads it already, they will be back as hidden. Should be looking like this. As you can see right there, a preview on the left side is much more cleaner. And for here, in message list, you can also hide them or show. Again guys, before I wrap this feature up, this is entirely depending on your own preference. Alright? Let's move on for the next feature. Now for the next feature, this is going to be categories, which is I accidentally described it earlier. So again, if you show this one, you're going to have those categories right there. But personally for me, I want to hide them. And now for filters, if you click on filters and black address, you can import someone else's filters. Basically add some categories, some labels on your own very own Gmail. However, you need to import them first and ask for permission. Again, under label, you can hide or show whatever you want to see on the left side of your screen. Now for the next feature, this is going to be under advanced. And look for the one that says templates. Right now it's currently enabled on my end. And how does it work? This is actually a good one. Go back on inbox. Think of an email that you always send on a regular basis. Now for example, on this one, let me just try this. Good morning. Something like that. Let's just say this is going to be the email I always send on a regular basis, right? So click on three dots right there. Look for templates. I can save this as a draft template. Save as new. That will be new template. Click on save. Now, whenever I add an email, for example, this is going to be a blank email, right? Click on the three dots right there, go to templates, and now you have so much choices to choose from. Starting from the one you did earlier, some previous I did from before. This is the one we did earlier. Let's choose another template. I'm going to go for this one. As you can see, you can add two templates at the same time. How powerful is that, right? So you don't have to really create and decide a new template and type it manually every day. Especially for someone that sends a very repetitive email. How awesome is that, right? Now for the next feature, this is actually a good one. AI in Gmail. How awesome is that, right? So under label, under general, under settings, should be around here. Look for the one that says smart. So that will be smart features and personalization and smart features and Google products. Make sure these two are turned on. And you're gonna see this one, that little star right there, that's Gemini. So think of it as ChatGPT inside Gmail. Ask anything, show unread emails, click OK, and right there, it will give you a summary of what are the unread emails you have. Now as you can see right there, it gave you everything you have there. Perfect, right? You can clear history, more suggestions, and it works. And not just that, I have covered videos having AI use in Gmail, especially for mobile devices, laptop, tablets, and computer. So please check it out. Because before, trust me, Gemini is a paid subscription tool. Right now, it's solely for free, free to use for everyone in Gmail. Now for the next one, under themes, under of course settings. Right now, I'm currently using the minimalistic Android settings, which is going to be for Android devices. And right here, it's really smooth and minimalistic. Now for this one, this is going to be under the mobile devices. Right now, I'm currently in the settings of Gmail. And right here, let's go first for the moving and swiping. How does it work? Under the settings, go for inbox customization right there and look for mail swipe actions. So I have two options, right swipe and left swipe. Right now, right swipe gives me the option to archive, left swipe gives me the option to move. With that being said, with this one for example, if I right side for this, they will go to archive, left side goes to move. As you can see right there. Pretty awesome, right? Now, also, this is only available for the device of mobile. Right here, if you go to inbox customizations, there should be the one that says this conversation list density. Now you can have an option if you want default, comfortable, or compact. Right now I'm currently on comfortable, which is actually a very good option. But again, that is going to be a personal preference. Now for this one, I have chat and meet here. Currently chat is currently off, and for meet, I have it turned on. Again, that is gonna be by your very own preference. Now if you're using iOS, for example, like this one, this is only available for iOS, which is the default apps. So whenever you open application or your link in Gmail, you're gonna have an option if you want it on Chrome, Google or Safari, or even Google Maps, Waze or Maps. Right here, I always click on Ask Me Which App to Use Every Time. That is actually my personal preference, but if you want to set it on a specific website, please do so. That will be depending on your own preference. Now lastly, this is also for iOS users. Under Data Privacy, if you click on this one, make sure you turn off Report Additional Diagnostics. However, for the Smart, two features make sure you turn on, especially if you're planning to use Gemini in your mobile devices. Alright? And with that being said, thank you so much for watching. Please hit the like button and subscribe. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Goodbye for now.